On June 11th of 2020, Sony released their new console, the PlayStation 5, which actually looks towering to the older consoles of the same series. In this video, I am going to compare the PlayStation 5 with the released Xbox Series X and have a good comparison in between these two brand new released consoles. So by saying that, welcome back to a fresh and new video of PyTech. Without any delay, let's get started. So as you already had a look at the montage which was played in the very beginning of this video, as you can see, the design of the PlayStation 5 is quite unique and it looks like someone stole the design from the future. I don't know why the internet is giving mixed reviews about the design of the PlayStation 5, but genuinely, if you ask me, I quite like the design of the PS5. This new console is using the new AMD SoCs with their 7 nanometer technology. So with the smaller processor comes greater heat. So what PS5 has done is it has a bigger body, so it compensates for the heat which the processor produces. And the graphics we're talking about here is the brand new AMD RDNA 2.0. So R suggests it has ray tracing, and also this console can support resolutions up to 8K. So that is one mind-blowing feature which consoles have got into it. And this console comes in two versions. One is the normal disc version and the other one is the digital version. And PlayStation also showed off their new gadgetry which comes with the PS5, their new PlayStation headphones, new controllers which looks sick by the way, and also the new 3D camera which can track your motions and you can play such type of games too. There were also some gameplay showed off in which some of the games were Spider-Man, Miles Morales, and also Gran Turismo's new game is coming out, and also the new Resident Evil game is coming out. Since it was just a hardware reveal of the PlayStation 5, no one could get to the price of it, but according to the internet, people predict that the price can be around a $500 to $600 gaming console. I don't know why still people are hating the design of PS5. I think it is quite good looking and also practical. They had to make the PS5 bigger and better because they have brand new processors and brand new graphics which is going into the PlayStation to give you such good performance in gaming. With the new console comes new controllers for the console, and this controller looks pretty good. It doesn't look like a PS controller, but it has the PS DNA in it. This new controller comes with haptic feedback features in it, hence the name changes from DualShock to DualSense. Get it? This controller gets extra buttons for your controls. For example, they have extra keys right behind your R2 and L2 keys, and also they have a share button in center of the controller. Coming to the design of the controller too, the internet is giving a lot of mixed reviews. People say that they don't like the new design of the controller, but genuinely, if you ask me, I love the design of the new PlayStation 5 and whatever they're doing with it, because even you see the color of the consoles and the controller, they are the signature colors of the PlayStation brand itself. And obviously, the charger which connects to the PlayStation and to your console too is through USB Type-C. So, shall we talk about the brand new Xbox Series X, which you see on paper is a bit more powerful than the PS5 itself. This Xbox runs on a 3.8GHz 8-core AMD Zen 2 CPU, which is very, very new. It's almost the same CPU when you compare it to the PS5, but this has higher clock speeds. When you see this console from a distance, you might confuse it to a new Micro ATX PC case or something, because it's pretty small. It actually looks like a small computer itself. So the one advantage where the Xbox Series X wins is it can sit at a clock speed of 3.8GHz constantly, Whereas in PS5, the clock speed has to vary because they have to avoid thermal throttling. But most of the hardware is matching to the PS5 when this has a graphics of the RDNA 2.0, which also supports ray tracing, obviously, in 2020. So here the Xbox has got better cooling, judging by the sheer size of the console itself, and also they got vapor chamber inside the console, which can help with cooling, obviously. And also the PS5 has managed to make the console size a bit bigger, but I would like to see the temperatures on both the devices when they get released officially. The controller of the Xbox Series X. There is little to no difference when you compare the controller of the Series X to the controller of the Xbox One, because the only thing they've added is the share button and a little bit of here and there physical changes. That's it. One thing which impresses me about these consoles is the graphics which these SoCs have got, which is the AMD RDNA 2.0. These graphics aren't even introduced in the PC market yet, but they got into the console side of the gaming market. So you can expect better gaming performance when you compare it to the previous versions of the console and also some high-end PCs too. So finally, to conclude the video, even though the Xbox Series X looks powerful on paper, you got to wait for the official release of both the consoles to compare them side by side in practical life and look at the performances they give. But if you ask me, in the aesthetic department, PS5 has won with their new brand new futuristic looking design, and also Xbox Series X looks good and it feels good too, but we have to wait for the official release to know more about the consoles. But there are still some YouTubers who have gotten their early hands-on experience of the Xbox Series X. You can go check out their videos if you want more information on the gameplays of the consoles. That's it for today then. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you like the video, do leave a like, and if you're liking my content, do subscribe to my channel. And as always, this is Pawan signing out.